for Jesus in your Christmas.
How many want to make room for Jesus this morning? How many can say, Lord, there's going to be a vacancy sign. There's not going to be a no vacancy sign in my heart. How many are going to make room for Jesus today? And for a few minutes, I want to talk about making room for Jesus.
Can I help you? My wife and I were trying to get home, but all the roads are blocked. Is there any chance you could put us up?
I'm sorry, we're overbooked as it is. I mean, if I had something, I'd give it to you, but... I mean, it's Christmas Eve, and there's no room at the inn.
What'd they say, Joe? Can they put us up?
And then, all the time when I left the door open, my dad would yell at me and say, "Were you born in a barn?" And I thought, well, Jesus was, so maybe I wasn't well.
What is the deal with this innkeeper?
Well, they want no room, no room at the inn.
It was late at night when Mary and Joseph reached Bethlehem. They were tired and hungry, but there was no room at any of the inns.
There's no room at the inn.
About ready for Jesus to be born, they were taking a big census, like they were counting everybody. And everybody was supposed to go back to the land of their fathers. And Mary and Joseph had to go to Bethlehem, because that was the city of David. But there were a lot of people who went to Bethlehem, way more people than normally lived there. And so there wasn't any room for them to stay. There wasn't any room in the inn.
No room at the inn. I said that to him.
The question comes to us today. Why did not the innkeeper make room for Jesus? In later years, when his fame spread throughout the land and he walked through Palestine, healing the sick, raising the dead, and feeding the hungry, the innkeeper probably reproached himself and said, "Why did not I make room for Jesus that night long ago?" At the moment, he had his reasons. Just as many today offer excuses for not making room for the Son of God in their hearts.
Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write His story? No room at the inn, they told Joseph. No place for Mary to sleep. Surely they could see how worried was he when told no room at the in a stable home, 'cause there's no room at the inn.
Lately, I've been stuck on the phrase, because there was no room for them in the inn. Bethlehem can't make room for the divine. Now, we could say their doors and windows to the mysteries of God were shuttered. And when you put it like that, it sounds awful.
No, I can tell you, I believe that Joseph frantically went from door to door, and he went from place to place, and he began to ask, is there any room here? Is there any vacancy in this place? My wife is about to give birth to a child. And the constant thing that he's getting is, I'm sorry, sir, but there is no vacancy. There is no room in this inn.
Then Joseph and Mary, who from David did spring, went up to the city of David their king. And there being entered, no room could they find. From the rich to the poor, they are mostly unkind.
Oh, I've got a Lulu for you this time. There's a guy out back with an extremely pregnant wife. And I don't think their donkey's gonna make it another mile. He's asking for whatever room we have available.
Now tell him there's absolutely no room at the inn. I feel for him, but I couldn't squeeze another person in here if he were the Messiah himself come to save me.
No room in the air. holds no place in their hearts that Christmas night.
Well, in today's lesson, we're going to take another look at the Christmas story. While Mary still had baby Jesus in her belly, she and her husband Joseph had to travel to a faraway place called Bethlehem.
When they got there, it was time for baby Jesus to be born. So Mary and Joseph had to find a place for them to stay.
But this turned out to be a big problem. There was no room in the inn.
There's no room. No room in the inn.
No room. No.
Said we best be going where sheep and cattle are lowing. He's got no room at his table. I guess we'll crash in this stable.